Welcome to Nature Book Review, a video showcasing books on nature and wildlife.
Can you hear bird calls behind me? Those are the ringneck parakeets or rose ring parakeets. There's a roosting colony on a tree behind me. It's early morning and the birds have woken up for the day. All of us know these parrots since our childhood. They are one of the most favorite of the pet birds. Since they are kept in cages, this has increased a lot of illegal trafficking in parrots. This has caused a heavy decline in their population in the wild. Some of the species have already gone extinct in the wild and they remain alive only in the captivity. Now, parrots are easily identifiable by their some of the characteristics. The beak. The parrot has short, stumpy, but a pointed beak which is used to break open the nuts and berries and fruits. Parrots are vegetarian predominantly. Now, other feature is the parakeets have short and stumpy leg. Their digits are arranged in a zygodactyly fashion. Means it helps parakeet to climb up the trees and do some acrobatics while feeding. There are some parakeets which sleep upside down like vernal hanging parakeet. Then there are other features like gaudy colors. This has made them one of the most favorite pet birds. There are different species of them. Parrots, parakeets, amazons, conures, macaws, cockatoos, cockatiels, budgerigars, lovebirds, so many and so forth. They are distributed throughout the world in tropics and subtropics. Now here is the book that tells us about the parrots. The Parrots by David Alderton.
Parrots by David Alderton. You can see there's an Amazon parrot on the front page. Let's go through the book. It is a Witted Book publication with illustrations by John Cox. First published in 1992. Witted Books Limited. Okay, what are the contents? Preface, in the beginning, what is a parrot, then everything about the parrots in basics, then lifestyles, people and parrot, postscript, already gone, it's related to extinction of the some of the species because of the pet trade, then further reading, societies and index. You can see the text is organized in single column with right side alignment. The text, the font is also crisp, readable. There are not many photographs in the book, but it is loaded with lot of information. There are black and white drawings of this parrots, different species of parrots. Okay, so let's see what it says here. Blue and gold macaw. Macaws were originally believed to occur around the eastern port of Macau, hence the name Macau. Interesting, Macau is in China, but they are found in the other part of the world, in the Amazon basin. There are few photographs, but not many. Then what is a parrot? What are the features that makes parrot its distinct bird? Now parrots, they have zygodactyly, means you might have seen parrot climbing on a tree and feeding on a nut while holding that nut into its legs. So they have that a bit of grasping capacity. This is a distributional map. Classification, then some of the silhouettes, how do they look? Now you can see it, this is a cockatoo. It appears a bit like a bird of prey, like an eagle or kite or something in the flight. Then these are the macaws. This is the feather structure. Eclectus parrots. Now this is called as Pesquet parrot. Is unusual in having largely unfeathered head like a vulture. It is sometimes called as the vulturine parrot. These are the head profiles of different species. Scarlet macaw, masked lovebird, Pesquet parrot, eastern rosella, kea, hanging parrot. So it tells us about the beaks. Though basic beak structure is same, but it varies according to their feeding habit. Because you know, kea is known to feed on the flesh or a wound. This is how tongue of a parrot is, brush-like tongue. Then the digestive tract. This is what is zygodactyly means. The arrangement of digit on the leg is such that they can grasp the berries and nuts what they are feeding on. Lifestyles. So this is the austral conure. It's found further south than any of the New World parrot. You can see it is found in the southern part of the South America, Chile and Argentina. A pair of Patagonian conures feeding this serves to reinforce their bond even outside their breeding period. Masked lovebird. Then this is a kakapo, a flightless parrot from New Zealand. Then different lovebirds, conures, gaudy colors. Then breeding. Parrots are known to breed in the holes. Then there are some parrots like this vernal hanging parrot. It's one of the most acrobatic parrot you can come across. So this is how structure of the parrot nest is. Parrots are known to be pest for some crops like this corn. Now parrots are one of the most favored pet birds, so that's why they are preferred by many pet owners, aviaries, breeders, etc. And this has led to a serious illegal trafficking of parrots. You can see there are drawings scattered throughout, but major part is occupied by the text. Then postscript already gone. So this is a Carolina parakeet, became extinct largely because of unregulated shooting. It was an easy target. The Mauritius parakeet is the rarest parrot in the world, with the cyclones now posing a constant threat to their survival. Mascarene parrot. Nothing was apparently recorded from the wild about this species, which became extinct by 1840, so long ago. Yes, and there's a further reading, and there are different societies related to parrots. Basically, they are about the breeders, aviculturist. I don't think there's a society related to conservation. Then of course index. So in all, this is a nice book to understand parrots, but the same author has written a big atlas of the parrots, but this is probably the smaller version of it. So of course it gives you a basic idea about the parrots. Overall, a nice book.